In this video, I will explain how to install Central Instance. Click Start. Click on Computer. Double click on C drive. Double click on Dump. And double click on Installation Master. Double click on this folder. Double click here. Double click SAP Install. Before double clicking here, just let me show you the database instance is installed or not. Go to Computer, C drive. This is the Oracle folder. Under Oracle folder, dev is the SID of the Oracle software, that is Oracle instance. Inside this, 102 is the actual Oracle home, that is the software is installed in this, and remaining all the folders belongs to SAP. So the database instance, while installing database instance, these folders will be created and all will be filled up with the data. If you see the properties, 19.4 GB it is showing. That means some data is there in that. And also the global host preparation also done. That is, USR folder is created. Inside USR folder, there is a SAP directory. In that, DEV is the SID, system identifier, that is SAP SID. In that sys folder, under that profile. So this is the default.pfl. This is the profile file. So with this only we can install another instances. That is, now we are going to install Central Instance. That is the main instance for connecting to the SAP system. So any user can log on to the system using the Central Instance only. Without Central Instance, there is no SAP system. Okay, so let us start the installation. Just double click on SAP Inst. And here this is NetWeaver 7.0 including enhancement package 1, support release 1. Just expand this. From here, SAP application server app, expand this. Under this, we are going to install it on Oracle database, that's why expand Oracle. If you are installing other databases, on other databases you can select any of these databases. So now I are installing the SAP system in distributed environment. That is, we are distributing the SAP system to different hosts, but I am using the single same host for installing all these steps, that is global host and database Central Instance. On the single machine I am installing. You can practice in different systems, different servers. Select Central Instance. Okay, and these two steps already done in previous videos. So now I am performing the Central Instance installation. Click Next. Typical, click Next. Here it will ask you profile directory. Profile directory can be browsed from run command slash slash. What is the global host of this machine? It is global host of this system can be find out from the command prompt. That is, host name is the command for getting host name. That is NW7EHP1 slash SAP MNT is the share name, slash DEV is the SID of the system, and sys slash profile. So this is the folder. Just control C or right click and copy. Go to the screen and right click and control V. Okay, it will be pasted. So this is the main reference directory to install Central Instance. So it will connect to the database instance and the global host directly, and it will start the installation. Click Next. And here you provide the master password, same password which we have entered in previous installations. Just click Next. Because OS users already created in the system, that is dev, ADM and SAP service dev, okay, it is asking to enter the passwords of those accounts. I have shown you already in previous videos how to check those users. Just right click on the computer and click manage. Go to configuration. click on local users and groups, click on users. These are the users which are created in previous installations, that is dev ADM and service SAP service dev. Okay, it is asking to enter those passwords. I'm using same password I can type here also. Just click next. It is asking you to give the path of kernel and Oracle client. Click browse, C drive, dump, kernel folder. This is the kernel. Click OK and Oracle client. So this is the Oracle client. Click OK. Click next. And it is asking you to give the path of sapcrypto.sar. This is for the purpose of HTTPS functionality. So right now you can deselect this option and click next. This is the parameter summary screen. From here you can revise any settings you want. The instance number is assigning here is 00. You can change the instance number if you want. So this is the first instance, that's why it took 00. If the second instance, that is dialog instance, it may be 01. Even you can change the instance number from here by selecting and click on revise, but I am accepting default. Okay, click next. And it is asking you to enter the solution manager key, so I have to provide it. I'm pasting the solution manager key here. And once you give the solution manager key here and click next. So within few minutes it will be completed. It is not database instance installation. It will not take hours together time. Only database instance will take more time. This should be completed within 5 to 10 minutes. So let me pause the video here. I'll come back with completion screen. So the installation is completed. This is the successfully completed message, that is SAP Netware 7.0 including enhancement package 1, support release 1, SAP application server ABAP, Oracle, distributed system, central instance has been completed successfully. Now click OK. So this is the final step in installing SAP systems. Now we can install SAP GUI software to log on to the system. I'll show how to install SAP GUI in next videos. Thanks for watching.